Well, hello my friends and welcome back to my channel. I am so freaking excited about this video, you guys. Krissyanne Designs has come out with some new paper, and thank you to Kristin and Damian of the Krissyanne Designs team for reaching out and seeing if I wanted to try out your new paper. And I'm very excited. I'm just very excited. As you guys know, I've been a huge Krissyanne Designs fan for the longest time. And I mean, I have a huge binder. I will link that Krissyanne Designs collection. I just did it not that long ago, up in the corner, wherever the heck it goes. But they are releasing new paper to their shop. It will be available on Friday, November 23rd. That is their Pink Friday. The new paper is also gonna be less expensive. It looks like about 15% off of the normal regular price, kind of across the board of their current pricing. A really fun thing about this as well is they are gonna be removable, which is awesome, because we all know that your girl makes a lot of mistakes. So it's nice when you can just peel that sucker up. There are also new markers and pens that you can use on them. So I'm gonna be doing a pen test, which this is like my pen test bin. So we're gonna do that, but I just took it out of the packaging and I haven't like smelled it. I haven't like really played with it or touched it. And I do have a regular like Krissyanne Designs sheet here from my binder. So let's play with this stuff. First of all, we need to talk about the feel. So like, I don't know. It feels very, very similar, y'all. Like, I can't really tell a difference, to be honest, with the feel of it. The next thing is the smell, because we all know that this smells like little, like, pool water wing floaty things. But what does this one smell like? It kind of smells... It smells about the same, to be honest. Yep, I'm gonna go with it smells the same. Yep, and I'm a little stuffed up right now, but I can still smell this. I can still smell a little bit, but I'm a little stuffed up at the moment. Darn Minnesota weather, you know? So, I wanted to test out some things because it says that all the permanent markers should work. However, they've been testing with ballpoint and rollerball pens, and some have required a little bit more dry time than others, but they are working on this paper, which is kind of awesome. And then some of the gel tip and felt tip markers don't always work, but they need a little bit more dry time if they do. So we're gonna just like test it all today and just like see what happens. So since I wanna write on things, I think I'm gonna choose this sheet to write on. And let's zoom you guys in a little bit. Like I said, I've got all the pens here. So let's start with the blue. Let's go from here. So this is a Paper Mate Ink Joy 700 RT 1.0 M. It's just like a ballpoint pen. So I'm just gonna, I don't know, I'll just write Inkjoy ballpoint. This is like really satisfying to write on. I'm just gonna wait a couple seconds and then, ooh, that didn't work out well. That's okay. Let's try another one and like give it a few minutes. I know some people love these type of pens versus like a gel pen or a permanent marker. We're gonna leave that for just a few moments. And to be honest, this is the only ballpoint pen I have, which is kind of crazy. I don't have another one. All the other things, because I personally, this is just me, I like to write in marker or in like a felt tip. That's totally my jam. All right, so it's been a couple of moments here and let's try this again. Okay, so it's a better, but it's not great. I wish I had more ballpoints to, test out for y'all, but I just don't have them. We're gonna do one more and then we're just gonna leave it for a little bit. Yeah, that one kind of got away from me, but that's all right. I want to try out a whole bunch of other things. So and I'm a person that doesn't really mind waiting for my things to dry, so whatevs. But okay, we're gonna try the Erin Condren medium. Oh, this for sure is not going to work. It's already like beating up. That's okay. We're gonna try all the things I have. This is one of those Stobolos. I don't know how to say it. Okay, this one doesn't work. And then we've got the Le Pen. Let's do some more of them here. Le Pen. That one might actually work. I don't know. We've got the Paper Mate Ink Joy Gel. So let's just, here, we'll put that one in here. One of my favorites. This used to be one of my favorites, but I don't know what is wrong with me. I think I'm like one of the only planner people that doesn't really like this pen anymore. I did until this sucker came out, and then I was like, nope, I am converted. This is the Pilot G2. This is the 10. I do like a broader tip, so I'm like an 07 or a 10 person in this. My issue with this pen is that it takes so freaking long to dry on just even regular paper that I'm like, eh, I don't know about that. So. We're gonna try it anyway because I have it. All right, oh, this is one of my favorites. This is the Jelly Roll, one of my faves. Let's start going over here. I think my pen is like dying. It's a very scientific review over here on the FDE channel. All right, well, whatever. Maybe it's not supposed to happen. Oh, that's another Le Pen, which is fine. Oh, I do have a white one. I will test that on another piece in just a moment here. This is my favorite permanent marker to write with. This is the Pilot Ultra Fine Point Permanent. So this is what I normally use on Krissyanne design stickers regardless. This is just a regular Sharpie. This should be just fine. And then I have one of these Microns, which are not my favorite. If you all have watched other pen tests of mine, you know that I don't like this. The reason I have these is so I can do pen tests for you guys, because I know everyone likes to write with something different. I think, to be honest, it's probably the tip I don't like, because it's an 03. If it was like an 07, I probably would be like not a problem with. I don't know. So, all right, let's try the Micron. Oh, it's not a Microm. Eh, whatever. All right, and then I've got the Flare. So the Paper Mate Flare, which I wasn't assuming would work just because this, the material isn't porous. So I didn't think that that would work. So anyway, let's try out this white pen on one of these bad boys here. I think I'm gonna try it on something I probably wouldn't use. So these like washi kind of strips, I'm gonna try it on this. And this is called the Uniball Signo. I did get these on Amazon a long time ago. And it's Uniball Signo UM-153. And there's like, you know, like symbols all over it. So I don't really know. I wish I knew more about this pen. This actually worked pretty good. It's like a little streaky, but that's because of the ball inside of the pen. Cool. All right, so why don't we check this out and see how everything did. So the InkJoy ballpoint now, it's not streaking. Ooh, looks like the pen, the Le Pen is a streaker. That's, oh wow, that sounded horrible. So is the Paper Mate Flare, which is fine. Okay, I need to like do something with my fingers. Okay, I'm gonna like touch the ones that I know are not gonna do anything. So the Pilot Ultra Fine, fine. The Sharpie should be fine. The Micron, ooh, the Micron. I thought the Micron would be like totally normal. Huh, weird. Okay, so we're gonna start at the things that I'm pretty sure are going to not work out, but we'll go from there. All right, let's
grab a dirty finger.
All right, the Eric Condren medium. It does streak, but you could have given a little, I could have given it a little bit longer, but that's okay. The Stabilo, that's the streaker. Jelly Roll, actually, if I gave that a little longer, it might have been all right. Okay, and then the gel pens are the big thing because, you know, we all love a good gel pen. So let's start with my favorite, the InkJoy Gel. Oh, that did not work out.
Let's wipe the finger off.
All right, and then the Pilot, nope, that didn't work either. But man, the ballpoint is kind of a game changer, I feel like. So very cool. Oh, I'm excited about all of these. Let me just peek through my black pens quick. I just want to see if I have any others. I don't think I do though. Nope, all the ones I have in blue, I have in black. So
it's a little redundant and a waste of perfectly good sticker paper to do this, right guys?
Okay, so let's check out the white one. Ooh, that's good. I like that. And to be honest, this is more of like a raised up, it's almost like a paint, it feels like. But I think you could have done this on the other ones too. Let me just, I'm gonna test this real quick. For whatever reason, it's like way more difficult to write on this paper than it was on this one. I don't know why. This paper like, to be honest, this paper seems like a little bit more, this is gonna sound weird, but like grippy, like not gritty, but like grippy when you actually like lay your pen or marker down on it, it feels grippier, where this is very, very slick feeling. So it's just like not picking it up, if that makes sense. I don't know if any of that makes sense to you guys. All right, so I wrote my little guy there. I'm gonna give it a second just to do that. But yeah, so let me give you some more information. It also looks like any orders after November 23rd and beyond will be using the new paper, and that the transparent paper, like the little, they've got like these little dots and little things that say like rescheduled or canceled or things like that that are transparent. Any of the transparent paper is not changing at this time. So they're gonna be staying with their standard transparent paper, which is not removable. So just wanted to let you guys know that. And let's check this out and see if this streaks. Nope, this is kind of the same idea. It's got, you know, it's more of that paint feel to it. So you could have used this on the original paper as well, but I had it, so why not use it, right guys? Okay, so I have a planner here. Let's try removing some stickers. All right, let's put some of these in here. Ooh, it feels so nice. I'm just gonna pull out the ones that I think were the best. Come on, here we go. The Pilot Ultra Fine Point, which is like my favorite thing. And then the Sharpie, which is amazing. Love a good Sharpie. And then let's pull this sticker as well. Ooh, look, you could like, if you're gonna be gone for a few days, you could like put this in this way. Oh, it's like almost perfect, sweet. Before, you couldn't pull up anything. So now, let's check this out. Oh my gosh, you guys, it's like freaking butter. It's like butter, oh my gosh. This feels so, it's so easy. Oh my gosh, I didn't know what I was expecting, but it's so easy, oh my gosh. Nice. All right, let's try another. Like, literally you just go like this and it like lifts just slightly and yeah, oh my gosh. These feel so nice and it like has all of its tackiness still. Oh, this is so good. I wonder how this would do like a year later or something. I mean, clearly as things like adhere, sometimes it's more difficult to remove or it loses a little bit of its tackiness if you keep touching the back of it with your lotiony fingers or your like kind of blue fingers like I have at the moment. You guys can't see it too well, but I got blue fingers. But anyway, but yeah, I would just be curious to know about that, but clearly that would be like a major test that we don't have time for today, y'all. We just don't have time. Oh my gosh, I'm so excited about all of this. This is so nice. And for people like me that put their stickers in crooked sometimes, this would be perfect because then you can just reposition it, no problem. And I'm gonna pull one of these out. I'm gonna pull out the one that I use, this Uniball Signo. So this is the one from, you know, just the regular sticker paper that I won't be able to remove. So let's put that one like down here. Can you guys see that? Nope. Why don't I put it in the frame, Emily? Seriously. All right, so let me put that down and then let me try to lift it up. Sometimes, to be honest, sometimes when you first put this down, you can lift them up okay, but once they've been in for like an hour with like the older paper, good luck. So you have to kind of use this product called Undo. See, okay,
I can remove it, but see how it grabbed all the paper with it? Hold on, sorry. Ah! I don't know if you guys can tell. Yeah, there we go. Like, yeah. So it like, it's all textured now and you can't reuse this. You just can't. Like, it ain't gonna happen, y'all. It ain't gonna happen. Oh well. But that's what happens to these. But like I said, if you guys use these and it isn't right away and you're not pulling them off, it's gonna possibly tear like a whole hole in your planner. Yeah, that's a lot of hole. Sorry. Oh gosh. Ah, we don't want to go forward. We want to go backwards. There we go. But it's just nice to like know how the new paper is. This is so cool, you guys. So yeah, I'm excited to check this out on Pink Friday, which is going to be tomorrow. Today is actually Thanksgiving and I am filming on Thanksgiving. And I am going to run upstairs as soon as I turn this video off and get this uploaded for you guys so you can check out my thoughts on this. I will leave links down below. I will also leave a link to Krissyanne Design's Facebook group and Instagram. I know a lot of other people are doing some sneak peeks and also giving their opinions on the new paper, and they might have more pens than me, to be honest. So you might want to go check out her Facebook group to just see what everyone else has to say about it. But yeah, I am so excited. Thank you so much to Kristin and Damian again for sending these my way. I think I'm gonna save this one because I really want to use this in an upcoming plan with me. I'm not sure when, but I want to use this for sure. So y'all will probably see this in the upcoming future. All right, but that's it for me. Thank you guys for hanging out with me today. If you're interested in Krissyanne Design's products, I will leave a link down below for you guys as well, so you can just check out her website. If you like this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up and feel free to subscribe to see more content from me, and I will see y'all in the next video. Bye guys.
Well folks, it's time to kick it old school. So you can feel cool. Give it to me, baby. Baby. Yeah.